TTS viewers and listeners, it's your guy NWB, and today I am joined, as always, by Mr. Justen Williams.
How's it going, guys?
Also joining us is a gentleman who hails from Mississauga and came through the ranks at our own Toronto FC. This winger from the West also wears red when he plays for his country, but not Canada. We'll get into that later. TTS Nation, I introduce to you Ryan Telfer.
Hey, Ryan, how's it going?
I'm going good, man.
Very good. Now, there's a lot going on in the world. A lot's happened in 2020. You were playing in Cyprus, actually, after you left TFC. But unfortunately, the league came to a halt, a pause. What was your emotions when that happened, when the league was put on hold?
It was expected, seeing what was going on everywhere else across the world. So it wasn't much a surprise to me, and as well as my teammates there. It was just rather expected, and it was just a matter of when it was going to be done. The surprising part was that a lot of big European leagues chose to restart in the later months. The surprise to us was that the league chose to shut down everything and call it a season. That was the most surprising part for us.
Interesting. So how has quarantine life impacted you as a football player for day-to-day life or soccer player? And what have you been doing to keep busy? Have you been doing reps? Do you have a Peloton bike? Like, we've seen that famous commercial. Like, what are you doing?
It's pretty tough in terms of I've always associated playing football to be with other people and playing with your teammates and stuff like that. And obviously playing against people that are on the same level and training with them is what makes you get better on the pitch.
Right.
In terms of being home and being quarantined, it all comes down to the mental capacity that you have and the discipline to be able to go outside every day and try to keep yourself fit and active and trying to push. It's almost like preseason in some words, where the idea is that although you're not playing right now, you're not be able to kick a ball with your teammates. It's about trying to better yourself strength-wise and mental-wise and physical-wise and just putting in the extra work to help prepare yourself whenever football starts back.
Right. Yeah, that makes sense, because it would kind of get that preseason kind of vibe, right, where you have to – I'm assuming you get messages from your coaches and being like, did you run your 15K today, and like random things like that. But what has life been like in Cyprus for you? Do you Uber food to you? Like, how does this work? Like, give us a day-to-day kind of life for your life in Cyprus.
Normally it starts, first of all, my sleep schedule was a little bit whack. Even since I got there, it was hard adjusting to the time difference. But normally wake up around 9 or 10. I got accustomed to doing a 5K every morning and then proceeding to do, strength workouts after that. Eat breakfast and normally FaceTime call my family, a few of my friends, and then basically after that, play video games to just keep your minds off stuff. We were able to go to grocery and stuff like that. So I was able to cook for myself and whatnot, instead of having to rely on Uber Eats. And the sad thing is they don't have Uber Eats there, but they do have some restaurants. They do
have them.
But I try to stay away from that part of it, and basically just try to keep myself occupied. If I wasn't cooking, playing soccer in the house, doing keep-ups, or playing video games, really.
Oh, man of many talents, I see.
Now, were you on your own in Cyprus, or did you have people around you that you knew?
No, I was completely by myself.
Brave. I must ask, what's the dating scene like in Cyprus? What's it like with the ladies out there?
I didn't really pay attention to that part. For me, I wasn't the type of person to go outside much. And a lot of people that I've heard from say, you know, Cyprus is obviously a lovely place. It's like a Caribbean lifestyle, and there's a lot of places to see, a lot of beaches and stuff like that. But those things never entertained me, to say the least. And I mostly just stuck myself at home, really. And before that, it was either going to training and then coming back from practice and then doing it all over again every single day.
Business. I like that. Now, you touched on the Caribbean. Now, for our audience, Brian actually represents Trinidad and Tobago, who are known as the Soca Warriors. Tell us about your pathway to playing for Trinidad and Tobago, and how do you feel representing TNT despite living in Canada?
It's somewhat different, seeing that before leaving Trinidad, the whole idea was that, you know, you wanted to become a Soca Warrior. And then, obviously, as coming up here, you started playing in the Canadian soccer system, and then it almost turned to, well, I could represent Canada because I'm Canadian as well, and it was just these two things in my mind, is having a tug of war at each other about which one to represent. And I was hoping the time would have come where, you know, both teams would have recognized myself and give me a call up, and that's what it ended up coming to, really. And it was just digging deep, talking to my family a lot, and just trying to make a decision out of it. And obviously the choice was to, you know, stick to the place where I learned and lived on the way how football was taught and played, and that's what really stuck with me.
Amazing. Now, in 2026, the World Cup comes to North America. It's going to be hosted by Canada, the US, and Mexico. How excited are you for this? And I guess, how do you feel about representing TNT in Canada, potentially?
That would be something huge. That's the idea of actually playing a World Cup is something huge to me, and something that I aspire every day to achieve. And you know, again, getting to play in front of obviously Canadian fans, the Canadian fans that I have, would be something special. Especially, I have a lot of family up here as well. That would be something truly remarkable for me.
And it'll be interesting because the FIFA are looking to expand the tournament to 48 teams. So you would think that the three hosts that I just mentioned would qualify. So hopefully they do the right thing by CONCACAF as well as Asia and Africa, and make sure that those confederations get a good number of spots as well. Also Oceania, gotta look after Oceania.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm looking forward to hopefully the 2022 World Cup, and hopefully trying to qualify for that. That's what's on my mind right now, and that's kind of the main goal and focus in the next couple of years.
I was going to say that. It's like, that one's coming closer. I'm just talking about 2026. Yeah. Let's focus on 2022 here, guys. You know, assuming
about that. Yes, there is a World Cup in Qatar in 2022. Yes, there is.
World Cup. It's going to be altered. It's so bad. But anyways, moving forward. Great answer. I really actually, that was very long-winded and very thought out. But I'm gonna pick your brain a little bit with this one, sir. With the CPL going into its second season, or for our French people, 12e anniversaire, do you feel that this is going to better prepare Canada again for 2022-2026? Like, do you feel like it's going to help us grow and become more, I don't want to say legit, but a more fierce competitor than having the three MLS teams?
Oh, definitely. A few things one thing I learned when I went in Cyprus is everyone has this idea of in their head about the skill gap and the gap between the European countries and North American countries, right? And what I've seen is not that different. Because when I've grown up here, there's a lot of soccer-minded kids all over Canada who aspire and want to achieve that goal. And the whole matter was that in North America, there was no infrastructure to allow kids to go from that level to the pro level. And having CPL to come in within the last year, you could see the improvements it has made for the Canadian team and other international teams around the world, being able to recognize players and players being allowed to play at a professional level and express themselves and actually be seen from the respective national countries and whatnot. It helps a lot of people, and and especially in Canada in total. So this coming into the second season and third and fourth and day on after, things can only keep getting better for obviously Canadian soccer and everywhere else in North America, in my opinion.
Brilliant.
Fantastic. And how excited are you to be back at Europe 9?
Pretty happy, to be honest. It's mainly because I've been able to come back home to my family and stuff. And then obviously, again, to go back to a team that I just left last year and the same couple of guys that are there as well. It's just came back into the swing of things, really. It's like I've never left, to be honest.
Oh, that's amazing. But speaking of camaraderie and kinship there, sorry to cut you off, Nee, but like, do you still talk to your old TFC buddies there? And if so, what do you guys talk about? Just kind of like, hey, come to the CPL? Or like, what do you guys discuss?
One or two guys I talk to. Mostly, I play video games with Delgado, really.
Chile?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, what game? I'm so curious. Sorry to cut you off there.
Oh, we play, normally we play Fortnite, and then I haven't downloaded Warzone yet, but hopefully that as well. So we kind of catch up on things whenever we play with each other and whatnot.
That's brilliant.
Yeah. I've got one more question for you, Ryan. Now you played in Cyprus near Salamis, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep.
Which is based in the city of Famagusta. Now, they have a major rival, which is Anorthosis. I believe while you were there, they played two or three times. Talk us through that. It's a city rival. It's a big rival. What's the atmosphere like when you play those games?
It was a similar rivalry to what Toronto and Montreal was in terms of the atmosphere and the fans. And you could tell it on the faces of the players when you shake hands and whatnot. Like, you know, everybody came there, it all came down to business. And you could feel that playing in the games, and tackles were flying in. No one was taking any prisoners, to be honest. And it was pretty fun and so action filled. Like, I felt like I was watching and playing at the same time, to be honest. And just to be a part of it was breathtaking.
Oh, that 4-1 derby. Oh, I get chills. The miracle of Montreal. Oh, that's an amazing experience to relive.
Anyways. Fantastic. One last question for you, Ryan. What's something that you would pass on to some of the younger players that are coming up in Canada? What's some advice that you would pass along to them?
The only advice I'll give to them is that when it reaches the pro level, it's all about how much you love the game and how much you're willing to sacrifice for what you do. And it's, to me, and a lot of people that I see around myself, it was never about becoming famous. It was never about, you know, making money. It was never about those things. It's people surrounding that love football and they would do anything just to play the game for a minute in during the time of the day. And that what brings you to this level, really, is how much you love the game and how much you're willing to sacrifice. And that's what's going to take you, obviously, to the next level and obviously to the highest level that you could achieve.
Spoken like a true champion.
Hmm. Now, we appreciate your time here today, Ryan. Just before we let you go, Justin has prepared a game for you, so he's going to take it away.
Yes, sir. I got to get my reading specs on here. So this game is called Who Wants to Be a Mississaugian? So it's kind of a split off of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, but we have budget cuts, so you don't get a lifeline. Yeah. And you must answer all five questions, because if you get one wrong, you're just... And they're all kind of opinion questions, but this is according to various websites that I've researched on the number ones of what I'm about to ask. So, and we'll give you a grading point. There's five questions, so... And you're an engineer too, so let's do this. Question number one. Best ice cream parlor in Mississauga. Is it A, Murphy's Ice Cream, B, Dairy Cream, C, Scoops, or D, Yum Buds?
When I go to get ice cream, well, then again, I don't really eat much ice cream, to say, but when we talk about desserts, because I am a dessert lover, we go to Dimitri's. That's where we go to.
Ooh. Unfortunately, that's not one of the four answers, good sir.
So the answer is E. Correct.
Whatever, we'll give it to you. We need that bing sound. Be like, bing.
Right. Bing.
All right. Number two, the best outdoor parks in Mississauga. Is it A, Lakefront Promenade, B, Jack Darling, C, Mississauga Valley, or D, Lake Aquitaine?
Mississauga Valley.
Ah, that may be your opinion, but according to everyone else, it is Jack Darling. All right. Best malls in Mississauga. Is it A, Air Mills, B, Dixie Outlet Mall, C, Square One, or D, South Common Mall?
Okay, if I don't say Square One, I'll get ripped. So it has to be Square One.
You are correct, good sir. You are correct.
If you said anything else, you'd be back to Square One.
Pretty much.
Oh, my God.
Dad, I'll let myself out.
Please, there's the door. Four, best high schools in Mississauga. St. Joseph, St. Aloysius Gonzaga, Cawthra, or USCA Academy?
St. Joseph, of course.
You, again, I figured you would say that. but unfortunately, you were incorrect, good sir. According to stats, this one has 37 reviews and 5 stars all the way across the board is USCA Academy. I have never heard of them either, but their football team sucks. And last but not least, the best comedy clubs in Mississauga. Is it A, Yuck Yucks, B, Can You Make Them Laugh, C, Didn't Both Those Clubs Shut Down, or D, whichever one Justen Williams is performing at?
Ryan, I'm going to jump in here. This is like the last kick of the penalty shootout. And I should point out that Justin's a comedian, so you get this one wrong, it's like putting it over the bar. Okay, so don't think this one through.
I'm going with C. Then those boat clubs shut down.
You have become my favorite player ever. Actually, true story, not going to lie. Do you know a guy by the name of Skyler who played for TFC 2 by chance?
Skyler.
Name probably something. He was captain for a little bit.
What's his last name? Was it...
I actually can't remember his last name. I think it was Skyler Thomas, yes.
Yeah.
So I was doing a show at Yuck Yucks in Mississauga before it shut down, and his uncle was actually hosting. So Skyler came with like 4 or 5 other TFC players. And at the time, I wasn't watching soccer. So I get up on stage and I do a few of my jokes. And when I get off stage, Skyler comes to greet me. Yeah. Right. And he's like, and he shakes my hand and he goes, he's like, hey, are you a soccer fan? And I panicked and I was like, yeah. And he's like, oh, yeah, what team do you watch? And I was like, TFC. And he's like, oh, cool. Maybe I'll see you around. And I'm like, yeah, sure. And just walks away. I was nervous, man. I freaked out. And then I watched soccer after that.
So. Happy days. Did he get it right?
You know what? We're just gonna.
All right, we'll pay it. Yeah. All right.
We're gonna cut that in half the interview.
Apparently. In off the post. I like that.
In off the post. Yes.
In off the post.
He's not wrong, but he could have been better. His coaches are a little upset.
Doesn't matter how you score, just that you do.
True.
Yep.
Ryan, you've been a great sport today. We appreciate your time. It's good to see you back in Canada. We're going to be following your progress both at York 9 and also for the Soccer Warriors. Where can our audience find you on social media?
They could follow me at Telfer Ryan on Instagram.
Fantastic. Well, that's all for today, folks. It's your boy NWB once again. And this is Toronto Talk Sports and More. For the Lovely Six, let's connect.
Thank you for watching. Please click the like button and leave us a comment with your feedback. And don't forget to subscribe with notifications to see more engaging and interactive content. Toronto Talk Sports and More. For the love of the Six, let's connect.